Welcome to the Happy Workaholic Podcast. I'm your host, Kellyanne Gorman. Over the past 20 years, I've worked in beauty, luxury, corporate, and service-driven industries. I created the opportunity in these careers and in my own businesses that allowed me to travel the world, experience once-in-a-lifetime events, and build brands while providing my expertise to clients all around the globe. Life is short, and when you're given a second chance, you better believe I'm going to take it, celebrate it, and share it with you. This show is intended to elevate your mind, upgrade your business, enhance your life, and become part of a positive and uplifting community. If you are ready to take your business and life to that next level you deserve to be at, this is the show for you. Inspiration, motivation, and determination are what got me to where I am today. Tune in every week to hear from myself, other entrepreneurs, professional patients, small business owners, and fellow podcasters who will be featured on the show. I'm here to remind you to work hard, share your story, follow your dreams, and never, ever give up. Thanks for taking the time to subscribe to the Happy Workaholic Podcast. Today's episode starts now. Hey friends, welcome back to a brand new episode. Today I'm going to share something a little bit different with you. So I am on a weight loss journey. My goal is to lose 100 pounds at the end of the year. And I'm doing this because I've gained about 80 something throughout chemo and the stress and when I was sick and misdiagnosed and all that fun stuff. So now I am healing my body with food. If you follow me on Instagram or Facebook, usually Instagram stories is where I post most of my recipes, but I do also post them in my Facebook group. However, I just like to keep things really simple. I don't add measurements, I just add ingredients. So it's up to you how you want to cook certain things if you're following any of my super simple recipes. So in order for me to lose this weight and in order for me to feel good and not be like craving like a ton of shit, I need to be, for me personally, I meal prep. And I meal prep because I need to be organized in literally every single thing I do. So cooking for me is like, it is so therapeutic. If I'm having a stressful day, I'll just clock out, get off my computer, and make some delicious meal. And then I'll make more, so I have extra, right? I'm also the queen of using what I have. And I just made the absolute best stir fry for the next couple of days. I think I made 1, 2, 3. Oh, I made 5 portions. So for the next 5 days, I'll be eating that delicious stir fry. And I'm trying not to. So here's how I'm going to lose 100 pounds. I'm going to choose healthy habits, move my body, and try to eliminate things that don't work for me personally. Now, before you try to pitch me whatever you're selling with your food situation and all of that, I have created my own kind of meal plan, really. I mean, I'm just eating as many vegetables as I possibly can, and fruits I put in my protein shakes, and I've just always loved green vegetables, so that's not hard. I don't eat seafood. I'm trying to eliminate dairy and sugar and salt for sure. And that's for medical reasons, because when you have an autoimmune disease, salt and inflammation is no bueno. And I have a very serious vertigo problem where my eustachian tube gets swollen. Before I need to tell you like all that fun stuff, I just can't have salt. So I'm supposed to have 1500 milligrams of sodium. I have about 1,000 or less because I'm cooking my own food. I actually don't even put that much pink salt in my food anymore. I do it after, not while I'm cooking it. So when I taste it, I'm like, oh, this needs a little salt. I'll put it on the prepped meal, so the portion I'm eating. That's how serious it is with the salt. With the sugar, sugar turns to fat. If I want something, I'm going to have it, but I try to eliminate it because that's obviously going to help me lose weight. And it's also good for, you know, the healing process. I'm trying to heal my body inside. This isn't a normal weight loss situation. Like, I literally just want to heal my body. And when I tell you I can feel inside, like when things are helping, like, I'm not even kidding. Like, do you ever have a craving and you're like, oh, I really want that chili? And it's a comfort food, right? Well, I crave things that will like help my stomach feel better or like give me energy. Like, those are things I crave now. Like, a sweet potato I'll make like a sweet potato chili with maybe ground turkey. I've been craving ground turkey for a couple weeks now. It's like the weirdest thing. And I eat it. If I'm craving something, I eat it. And now I'm really paying attention. So I'm really trying to stay away from dairy, sugar, and salt. And that is for health reasons because I'm healing my body. In the process, I would like to lose 100 pounds. And guess what? I'm almost at 25 and we're not even at the end of February. And side note, I have not been to the gym. I've been doing my walks on the beach and just keeping my mind sane. That's how I'm losing weight. I'm moving my body like my good friend Heidi, which you'll hear about in a minute, has taught me. She's such an inspiration. And I'm just eating whatever I want. Like, for example, okay, so tonight's stir fry for the next few meals. And by the way, look at my Instagram on the highlights for recipes and you'll see what I'm talking about. So I said earlier I like to use what I have. So when I used to juice all the time, I used to juice every single morning. But for some reason, that's like disrupted my insides. So now I have moved to the protein shake lifestyle, which is so weird because I've been juicing for years and now it's just like ripping my insides apart. I don't know why. So, you know, our body changes and I just need something more like soothing to heal, I guess, in the morning. So, and I'm going to tell you like my favorite things that I like, and then I'm going to tell you that everything is available on my Instagram under recipes. So don't think I'm going to be giving you any, you know, measurements. You're going to go to my Instagram, you're going to screenshot it, and then you're going to create it yourself because cooking should be fun. It's not stressful, you know? So, okay, so the stir fry I just made was Brussels sprouts and broccoli and jasmine rice with a little bit of olive oil, and I put in a blood orange with garlic. First of all, I had two oranges in the fridge. I did not know that they were blood orange. I'm so excited because they've been in there for like 2 weeks, and I'm like, oh my God, I could totally make the most delicious Asian teriyaki-ish without like the teriyaki sauce and just infuse it with citrus. So that's what I did. It's fucking bomb. It's so good. I did not mean to just drop the F-bomb, but like that's how delicious it is. And it's so simple to make. You just throw some olive oil in the pan, saute on medium the broccoli and Brussels sprouts. And I really wish I had green beans. I swear that I had them. So I'm actually going to add more of those. I'll get them tomorrow and add it per portion. And then I just added garlic and oregano and black pepper and the blood orange. That's it. That was my meal. So I portioned those out for 5 days. Now, going back to using what you have. So I went to Vegas for 1, 2, 3. I was there 4 days. So before, when I was leaving the night before, I hate wasting food, like absolutely hate it. And I had a whole bunch of things in the fridge and the freezer. And I'm like, oh my God, I need to just like make a soup. And this is what I always used to do when I have leftovers. Like when, if you're somebody that's juicing and you have ingredients that are like ready to go, what you do is you make a soup with them. And I used to add apples and ginger like to my veggie soups. And you guys, it adds like such a sweet flavor to the broth. And the broths, broths, plural, that I use, it's water. And I usually use fresh herbs like parsley and cilantro and scallions to flavor, or I use salsa. But now I'm trying not to do the salsa because of the salt situation. So I'm just flavoring the broth with different herbs and it's so good. So I had a bunch of celery and onion and the fresh herbs, like I mentioned, and fresh garlic. And what else did I have? Couple other things. Oh, carrots, apple, ginger. So all of that was going to go bad because I wasn't going to be around. I was gone for 5 days. And 5 days before I came back to the house. And so I just prepped everything. What I did was I got a huge pot and I dumped and I just prepped everything like I was going to make a soup that night. So then I put it in a Ziploc all chopped up. So I had, what did I do? I did peas and green beans and celery and cilantro and parsley and carrots and apple and ginger and like a bunch of other things, which you'll see on my recipes on my Instagram. So I just chopped all that stuff up and I threw it in a big bowl, mixed it up, threw it in a Ziploc, threw it in another Ziploc, thank God, because that onion was so potent. Thank God I double bagged that thing. And then I threw it in the freezer. So when I came home, all I needed to do was throw it in the microwave for like 2 seconds, defrost it in the pan, add the broth, and what else? I put some other veggies in there, and that's it. That was my soup. I've been eating this soup. It's literally the best soup I've made in so long, and I'm like, I wonder if it's because I chopped everything up and had it already like ready to go in the freezer. Usually that only happens when you marinate things, so I don't know. This onion and the flavor, oh my god, you guys, it's so good. So I've been eating that the last couple of days. Now, one of the questions a lot of people ask me is like, how do you eat the same thing all the time? And for me, it's just an organizational tool. Like I'm so good on shopping for groceries, and also I'm not eating a lot of meat, and I don't eat a lot of processed crap, and that shit's expensive. When you actually go, I mean, I'm in San Diego, and even though I'm in San Diego, I talk to friends in other cities, and I mean, how many grocery stores do you need to go to get everything? I go to 3 just to get my money's worth. And before I went to Vegas, I spent $20 at Sprouts on the produce because they have the best organic produce, $20 at Trader Joe's for my frozen veggies and the salsa and I don't know, whatever else I got, probably wine. And then if I go out to eat, I have more money, but I have a trick for that too, to save money and be healthy. And I did it the entire time in Vegas, and I'm so proud of myself. So I'll tell you about that in a sec. But I am so good with budgeting food. It's like unreal. I can get, so let me just tell you what I eat. And I don't know, I've just been doing it for so long, I don't get sick of it, but every now and then I will. And so I have backups in the pantry, in the freezer, like things I can make that I'm like, I'm so over my prepped meals, and then I'll have something else. And plus, I get bored if I can't cook for like 5 days, like I'll lose my mind, because that's like really therapeutic for me. So in the morning, what I'm having right now is a protein shake with spinach and kale, blueberries, cranberries. Now I can't find any more. So I actually do Dr. Stephen Gundry's Reds, and it has all these amazing vitamins in it. So I use that since I can't find cranberries anymore, and banana and cinnamon. So I actually use 2 of my big ninja jars, I blend them, and that creates 3 mason jars worth of a shake. So those are prepped, and it does not get gross. I have friends like, oh my god, I can never do that. Like, I have to make my shake in the morning. And I'm like, listen, you want to save time? You do it at night. I won't have my shake, and I won't even eat until noon if it's not ready the night before. I'm too busy, and I need to just grab it and enjoy my shake, you know? And I usually do intermittent fasting because it's really good for people with autoimmune diseases. And again, I'm just sharing things that are helping me heal my body and medical decisions I'm making. Not like I'm starving myself of, and prepping because I'm like binging or I'm, you know, ODing on sugar. Like, I'm not doing any of that. Like, I prep for organization. I prep because I'm so swamped with work. I prep because I like to be organized. I worked on yachts for years, and I have so many photos of my fridge on Instagram stories. It's like insane. Like, I just have this system, and I've always been like that. And plus, it's convenient. It's like, who doesn't want to just grab something and go and like stay healthy and continuously heal your body? That's my mission. So I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just sharing all the tips and tricks that help with me when it comes to healing my body and giving it what it needs. And I'm not even kidding. Like, I know what it needs. I can feel it. It's like a psychic ability now. It's so crazy. So I have my shakes in the morning. Well, honestly, I have them around like 11 or 12 because I do the intermittent fasting. So I have that. And then like this week, I have my soup that I was just telling you about. And now I have my broccoli, blood orange, rice, Brussels sprout, adding green beans, stir fry. So I'm going to eat that for the next couple of days. And then, you know, if I need sugar, I'm going to eat it. Like the other day, I'm like, I haven't had ice cream in so long. And I bought mint chip, which is my absolute favorite, from Trader Joe's. And those delicious little Reese's nuggets, they're like the dark chocolate peanut butter nuggets at the register for 99 cents. You know what I'm talking about. I know you've had them. Anyway, I put them in the freezer. My old self would have like the whole damn bag with a bottle of wine. My new self now, I have 2 and I want to throw up because the sugar, like, it makes me feel hungover the next day. And I'm like, ugh, but that ice cream was just too much. Like, I haven't had dairy like that in so long. It was so good. But honestly, if you guys love mint chip like me, like peppermint, I need it ice cold. Like, I'd rather just have a frozen York patty. Just one. Like, that is my all-time favorite thing. And on, when was it Valentine's Day, I treated myself and CVS was having a sale. So I got one for $2 and my second for like a quarter. I'm not depriving myself of sugar. I don't need sugar. I'm not even having that much wine anymore either because of sugar and salt. And I'm just trying to drink a lot less. So I'm pounding my waters. I usually drink around like a half a gallon to a gallon a day. I was doing a gallon hard like for a while, but now it's just like I'm going to pound waters like when I'm thirsty, you know? So that's just what I'm doing with my meals, how I organize, and then what I'm eating. So check out my Instagram. You'll see the last meals that I just mentioned. And also, yeah, I do have recipes for my protein shakes there. I've been doing them for like 3 weeks now because I'm actually, my roommate gave me a new protein powder, which I'm excited to try. I've always been using a vegan sugar-free protein powder, and last time I got it was before like my nomadic adventures, and I got unsweetened instead of unflavored instead of vanilla, so the flavor is just like off. So my new one now is vanilla, and I'm so excited about it. You know, there's just certain things, and especially in the morning or like your first meal, you don't want to like be disappointed, you know what I'm saying? Also, the other day when I was at Trader Joe's, I got some brand cereal. My friends make fun of me. I never have cereal. It's usually when I'm PMSing, let's be honest. I'll need Cheerios or Rice Krispies. I usually hit up Cheerios first, and there's sugar, so I haven't been doing that. But this time I was like, I was just craving cereal, and I like all the cereals that you would probably see served in a nursing home. So like Total Raisin Bran and Grape Nuts. Grape Nuts is hands down my favorite cereal. Grape Nuts and Cheerios mixed up together, it's literally life-changing. Like, I could eat that every day, but I'm not. But I got these bran flakes, or bran, they're like twigs. They look disgusting, but they're so good. And they do have sugar and salt, but just a little bit. And the measurement is like a quarter cup. So you should only have a little because that stuff is so filling, but they have a shitload of fiber. So I'm like, that's a healthy choice. So I have that like as a backup meal, you know. The other night I had it for dinner. It was like the best thing ever. Makes you feel like you're a kid again. And yeah, so those are my meals. So now I want to share with you. So let's just do a little recap. I'm telling you what I'm eating, why I'm doing it, and how I'm healing my body. Excuse me, and how I save money when I grocery shop. I do beans and rice and quinoa and then just fruits and veggies, honestly. Salsa, I don't do any condiments. I just use olive oil, like super basic. Feel free to DM me if you want like my actual grocery list. Oh my God, I can't talk. It's not like super exciting, but when I do have something super exciting, I also want to share with you. So not sure if you know this, but making pizzas is like in my blood and I'm so freaking good at it. And I'm obsessed with it. Like, I swear I'll have a pizza shop one day because I'm just like obsessed with making like the most delicious, like healthy ingredients on a pizza. I've made all kinds. Like, I made tomato basil, barbecue chicken, roasted veggies. Oh my God, so many, so many. And now I'm even trying to perfect the pizza crust. And it's so funny because 2 years ago, which I can't even believe, I made this vegan pizza crust out of lentils. And I put salsa in it, so it made it like mush up. So when I put it in the freezer and parchment paper for like 2 days and it still didn't work out for me. So I had to start working on that crust because if you have lentils in the pizza crust, that's just like a protein. And then I barely have cheese, so I just like sprinkle a little bit on there and then whatever I want on top, whether it's like protein or veggies or whatever, it's so filling and delicious and you're getting like everything you need in your body, right? So I need to start working on that crust again. I'm also making a new batch of veggie burgers, which I'm super excited about because I honestly haven't made them in months. So the next time I go to the store in a couple days, I'm actually going to pick up everything I need. And I have so many veggie burger recipes on my Instagram. A couple other recipes I have on there are These are like my favorite go-tos, right? I have so many healthy soups. I have veggie burgers, vegan ice creams, all my pizzas, which I made one tonight and it was bomb. All different stir fries. Like, I just love cooking, you guys. And now that I can actually feel it's like healing my body and helping me lose weight, and I'm a lot less stressed, like, it's just going away. And I knew it would, because you have to have a positive mindset. And I just know, like, if I move my body, I get outside, I get fresh air, and I eat foods that are going to heal internally, I'm going to lose weight and it's just going to fall off. And that's what it's doing. And I'm not doing anything crazy. I'm literally just eating things that will help my body, because I'm withdrawing from 12 meds and chemo and all these other things. So for a while, it was really, really hard to do that. And plus, I was so stressed out. Now it's happening. So I'm so excited about it. So side note, today was one of those days that I took a field trip because I needed some delicious food. Now I want to talk to you guys about, if you are somebody that works online or you have a brick and mortar and you just have a crazy busy week, I'm telling you, you need to be organized and prepared and prep your meals. It will make your launch week or your crazy business week, or if you have a ton of children's events, you know, like if you have children and you have like a lot of events going on, if you have your dinner ready at night, if you prep your breakfast in the morning, like, it's going to be save you so much time, money, and stress. I'm not even kidding. So, because I have a launch week, the next 2 weeks solid, I just launched my Leverage Your LinkedIn, the masterclass, and I have a lot of producing to do. I mean, like, show after show after show after show in the middle of a launch. And the only thing that keeps me satisfied and not stressed is having my healthy meals ready. However, when it is launch week, I do need to take a break. So that's what I did. I knew I would be working super late tonight and up again early tomorrow. And Friday pizza, like, I just grew up eating pizza on a Friday, and that's just like my favorite thing. And I went to the international market today, which I'm obsessed with. I always get my falafel pita there. I get my halva there. If you don't know what halva is, H-A-L-V-A. Oh my God, you're missing out on life. The pistachio is bomb. Today I tried a Russian marble one and it just wasn't up to par. So I'm not even going to like keep it in the house. I just need to throw it away. But pistachio halva is literally the best. They also have a baklava bar, like a whole entire area of baklava. It's on my Instagram. I've posted it a million times. It's so good. But because I'm trying not to have sugar, I just get like a little tiny sample. And then I move on with my life. And then every now and then I'll treat myself and I'll have one. But, oh my God, it's like somebody's grandmother is in the back making it. If you guys have an international market by you, please go. It'll change your life. I'm obsessed. I don't know if it's just from, you know, being able to travel for so long, or, I mean, honestly, I feel like I was doing it, like, I would go to international markets, like, before that. I don't know. But I just love cooking with Persian spices. I'm obsessed with sumac. It's red. It kind of looks like paprika, but it tastes citrusy. And if you've ever had Persian food, it is served always with Persian food. And it's so good. Fresh dill. So I get my falafel there, my halva, and this bread they have, and I always forget the name, but I posted a photo on the gram earlier, and they bake this bread. It's so long. It's literally like the length of like your kitchen table. And I got a small piece. They had two round ones, but I was like, that's way too much, because I don't like to have a lot of food around. I just like to have like backups, not just like all the bread. Bread is like my downfall. I cannot have any extra bread around. So I got the small one and I still only made half, and I made a huge pizza. So I used this Persian bread, and then I put some olive oil, and then I sprinkled a little cheese, and then I sliced up the tomato, and I also forgot fresh basil, because my whole plan was to make a margarita pizza on this Persian bread. So I just added garlic and it was all right. I mean, it was good, but like that fresh basil, man, it's such a difference. So I had my margarita pizza minus the fresh basil. I just did the dry basil, but it was so good. And I had that tonight because I needed a break. I've been producing shows like back to back to back for all my clients. I'm launching, I think, 4 over the next couple of weeks, which is nuts. Also in the middle of a LinkedIn launch, like I have to film all day tomorrow. It's just so crazy. So I needed a break and I made my stir fry, like I was just saying, and then I made this delicious pizza. And it's so good on the Persian bread. And because the olive oil made it like crispy, so it wasn't like a thin crust, it was a little bit more elevated. I would say like a fluffy pita bread consistency. So that's what I had tonight. And so I want to share with you now. Okay, so if you're crazy busy during the week, you have a launch week, you're busy with work, you have a lot of kids, you just want to save yourself time, money, and stress, like this is what you do, okay? Now, continuing on to travel and saving money and still being consistent, say you're on, a health, like healing journey with your body like me, or you just want to eat healthy, you don't have to do anything that I do. I just was determined to feel my best going to Vegas because I don't really feel my best going there. I don't feel my best being there. And I don't feel my best until I like feel the ocean breeze when I'm back in San Diego. And that's just like a whole trauma situation. But I needed this trip to be different. I'm trying to move on with my life and I'm trying to feel better. So by bringing what makes me feel better and feel good every day with me, that will happen. So I brought my oil diffusers, my oil. I forgot my pink lamp, which I was so annoyed about, but I brought my comfy PJs and all my comfy socks. And I'm trying really hard to pack a lot less because I was a little digital nomad for a while. So I've got my packing down. So this trip, you guys, I'm so proud of myself. So what I did was, first of all, if you don't know about my iced coffee situation, now you know. Go look at my Instagram under like the nomad highlight because it took me months to figure out my iced coffee situation traveling. But now it's easier like on a trip, right? Because I drove to Vegas. So I made my iced coffee. It's always made. So what I did was I poured it into a water jug with the almond milk. So I brought a whole jug with me. Then I have these cubes that you just throw in the freezer so that they're ice cube. They, you know, those like little party cubes. So I have those. And then I brought my stevia and my metal straws. So, and my big cup. So when I went to my Airbnb, when I had the fridge, well, there's a fridge. So I put in the water jug that was in there. My coffee was already ready. So all I needed to do was just pour it over my cubes, squirt a little stevia, and move on with my day. And my iced coffee is there. I didn't spend any money on any coffee going out. My coffee's 10 times better. It doesn't have sugar that's going to give me cavities. Like, it was amazing. Now, I did the same thing for my shakes. I made my shakes in advance. So in the beginning, I was like, okay, I have my huge purse, my huge bag of like clothes and shoes and all that. And then I had a present bag, then I had a food bag, and then I have my office bag. So it's like a lot's going on, right, guys? So I was trying so hard to like streamline like and downsize, even though, you know, I needed a lot of stuff to come with me. I prepped my protein shakes for 4 days. I'm telling you, in the mason jars, they stay so fresh. And they were in 5 without being in the fridge for 5 hours because I brought a cooler and ice, so they stayed chilled. So I checked into my Airbnb, I put my coffee in there in a gallon container, and then I had 4 mason jars, and they each had my protein shake. So in the morning, I just woke up at like 6, I was up at like 5 and 6 most mornings, working on shows, and then I could make my iced coffee. I could make my protein shake. I never even left the house till like 10 or 11. And then one day I was like in back-to-back meetings, but I was living my best life. I didn't spend any money. Like, I brought everything with me and it was so amazing. So if you can do that when you're traveling and go to an Airbnb and like transport things already made, that's key. Because like I was saying, I, the night before, took everything out. So I have my protein powder, my chia seeds, my, the red powder I was telling you about. And then I had like all the, I wasn't going to do obviously like the frozen fruits and veggies in the smoothie because I wasn't going to be able to bring them. But then I was like, wait, if I make it like I usually do, then I can bring it with me. So that's what I did. I saved so much money I probably saved $100 not having breakfast or coffee out. And that was key. And that's important for me because, again, I'm healing my body. So I need these certain things. I can't find exactly what I need and what my body is used to out at a smoothie place. Like, they don't have what I need now. So it just makes even more sense. And now what I'm doing, so if you're trying to lose weight and you're on a weight loss journey, or you're just trying to save time and money, or you want like a little treat, my new thing is to get a kid's meal. So, well, it kind of backfired. Let me tell you about how it backfired on me the other day. So I had to starve all day because I needed to get a CT scan of my stomach. So I had my smoothie at 8 a.m. and then I couldn't eat until 4:30 after it. So here I am thinking, and there was a Chick-fil-A across the street. So I already knew that was happening as soon as I left because I was like literally nauseous because I was so hungry. And that iodine they give you was just, oh, it was awful. So here I am thinking I'm going to make a smart choice. I go to Chick-fil-A, I get a kid's meal, and I got the grilled chicken. Holy sodium. I mean, if you're going to go to Chick-fil-A, just get the damn Chick-fil-A nuggets and call it a day. So now I know for the next time. So going back to Vegas, I went out one day, I had two little burger sliders, no cheese, just plain, and then carrot and celery sticks. And that's the like a normal portion that you should be eating anyway. And it was so good. Another day I was out to lunch and I had steamed broccoli with buffalo chicken tenders, an appetizer. So it was a smaller portion. And what else? Oh my God, I don't even know. I denied ice cream and denied, what's that burger place? Another one. But I am trying so hard. Like if I want something out, I get sides or I get a kid's meal. Like if it's a drive through or like any kind of restaurant where they're not like offended and tell you like, no, you can't have that. You're a grown adult. You can't have a kid's meal. So it depends on the situation. So I would just get like a bunch of sides. And so I went to Chili's with a friend where I had the steamed broccoli and buffalo chicken tenders for the appetizer. And we had chips and salsa, but I knew like that's a serious sodium meal for me. So I had to have two water pills. That's just like kind of the medication I take now for my ear, which is like the vertigo issue. I'm not popping water pills like for another crazy reason. It's so I don't get vertigo. So if I have too much salt, that will give me vertigo. So when I pop the water pills, it prevents that. So if I'm having something that has too much salt, then I know I have to take a water pill. And my doctor tells me this. So this is why. So I just like am so excited to be sharing more of my personal life with you guys and like what's going on with like my weight loss journey, and honestly, it's to heal my body. I just need to get back to where I was before all the stress and disease and drugs and all this shit entered my body, and that's it. And I'm moving my body, and I'm meditating, and I'm getting like all the woo-woo stuff. I'm looking at my new crystals on my desk. I have a sage spray. I've got some incense going. I went to some woo-woo store today and I was just living for everything there. I wanted to get so many other things. This incense, man, though, that is so strong. The Palo Santo or whatever it's called. God, that stuff's strong. Anyway, I love it. And I love sharing my healthy journey with you guys. And obviously earlier I said, you know, I was really inspired by my good friend Heidi and how she's always talking about being joyful and moving your body and all of that. So I just wanted to share something really important with you guys. If you're looking for a certified food and body coach, Heidi is your girl because she helps women ditch dieting and reclaim their body joy. If you guys don't follow Joyfully Be, which is Heidi on the gram, you need to. She's on her trampoline jumping. She's outside moving her body. She's so inspirational. She wants everybody happy and joyful and living their best life. And if you guys are interested in hiring a certified food and body coach that is going to light you on fire and just make you feel so good and want to move your body, you don't always need a trampoline, but you need to move your body because that's just what you should be doing and drinking lots of water. And she has an amazing deal right now that I just have to share with you guys. If you, in the month of February, we only have about a little bit over a week, sign up with Heidi for her 5-month Joyfully Me group coaching program or her one-on-one coaching, she's going to give you 50% off. So you just need to mention this podcast. Visit Heidi over at Joyfully Be on the gram or joyfullybe.com. I'm going to list all of that in the show notes. But I think that you guys should really check it out because I've just honestly never been so inspired and so moved. And I understand that certain things need to happen when you are trying to heal your body or you are on a journey. And if you are with somebody that's continuously inspiring you and helping you along the way and helping you move your body and just like reclaim the joy that you're missing in your life, like what else do you need? So I just wanted to share that with you guys. I'm going to, again, put all of that info in the show notes. So I would honestly talk to Heidi this weekend, talk to Heidi next week, because as I'm looking at my calendar in front of me, the 29th is the last day. So you only have about 8 or 9 days. So take advantage of that 50% offer. You cannot go wrong. And if you have any questions, just shoot her DM. So I hope you guys enjoyed my episode today. It's a lot different than the rest, but you know, I'm moving into more entrepreneurial episodes. Oh my God, can you tell I've been recording all day? And I just want to share with you guys things that are working for me. You know, I like to be organized with my meals. I like to be organized with my work, with my life, like everything. So I also am obsessed with cooking because it's very therapeutic and I just love using like fresh ingredients and I love saving money and time, and especially during a busy work schedule or a life schedule, or for me right now, launch week, I need to save time, money, and energy. And by doing that, I prep my meals, make super delicious food, and that's it. Like, I just like to keep things short, sweet, to the point, although this episode is kind of long, but you know what I mean. So if you guys like anything that I was discussing earlier on my recipes, I know it's kind of hard to like visualize, but guess what? They're all on my Instagram. So just scroll through the highlights and I'll also post the stir fry and my pizza and the soup, the last batch of this week's meals, because I think those are the only ones I made. Yeah, because I just came back from Vegas. So if you guys have any questions about traveling and food prep and just like being organized and healing your body, reach out anytime. If you are trying to reclaim joy and with your body, reach out to Heidi because she is your girl. I hope that you guys enjoyed this episode and I'll be back with some more recipes soon. Your time is so valuable, and I really appreciate you carving out a little piece of your day to listen to today's episode. If you liked this one, please share it with someone who you feel needs to hear this message. And don't forget to tag me at The Happy Workaholic on Facebook and Instagram so I can feature you on my stories. Listening on Apple Podcasts? I would love it if you would leave me a review on today's show. Your input means so much and also helps me create more of the content you'll love. Want to continue today's conversation? You can join us in the Happy Workaholic Network Facebook group. Simply answer the questions and you're in. For more information on myself and to get the latest in business, LinkedIn, organizing, and podcasting news, sign up to receive my weekly newsletter at thehappyworkaholic.com. I hope that your day continues to be happy, healthy, positive, and productive, and I'll talk to you again soon.